what time it is. Welcome to my channel. My name is Naomi underscore Imparable. I think my music is really loud, so I'm really shouty. I'm gonna turn it down real quick so that I can stop screaming at y'all. Okay, sorry about that. I'm excited today. I always say I'm excited every time I do a video because it's always something that I'm so excited about. What's the purpose of the channel if you're not excited about it, right? No, but I'm making guacamole. I love a guacamole just to have it, you know, and to eat on it, munch on it. It's so easy to make. It's so easy. Anybody can make it, I promise. If you're new to my channel, I forgot to say welcome. Welcome. If you're not new, welcome the back. Just kidding. Not kidding. I love you all. Thank you for watching my channel. Every single one of you. I make guacamole often. Problem is it spoils fast sometimes, so you gotta like know when you're gonna make it and know what you're gonna eat with it and how much of it you're gonna eat. Otherwise it's gone. It doesn't last very long, not even in the fridge. There's some tricks they say you can do to like preserve it a little longer, but I ain't got time for all that. If I want guacamole, I'm gonna make it, I'm gonna eat it. That's it. Okay? Alright, so I'm going to go to my kitchen and get started. I am gonna say that I cheat a little bit. I am more modernized, if you want to call it that, or whatever. I make guacamole the easy way because your girl doesn't have time. Okay, I work. I'm a single mom. I have a kid to take care of. I have a house to clean. I have all these things on my list, plus doing what I love, like, you know, recording videos and all that, and socializing and getting out. There's no time. Anyway, if my grandma saw me making this guacamole, she would probably slap my hand and get so angry. If a few of my friends who are a little culturally positive, we'll say that. That's a nice way to say it, but they would too also be like, why are you cooking? That's not how you make guacamole. You're not doing it the right way. I get it. You know, it's tradition, it's cultural. And it's not just that. There's an effectiveness to it. I'm sure there's a method to it that makes it taste a certain way as well. But like I said, I don't got time for that. This is just my preference. If you want to, you can go out and buy the traditional tools to use for this. But let's get started on the guacamole. All right, I got my ingredients all ready to go. This is my, dare I not say, or dare I say, tool I used to make guacamole. It's not dirty, don't worry. It's just like old, scratched up and stuff like that. This thing is really old. It was handed off to me by someone else. And yeah, anyway, it is a, see that? The little blades, chop it up, you spin this thing and chop, 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 chop. So fast, so easy. Yes, 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 don't be mad at me, grandma. It's okay, it will all be okay. Anyway, what I was saying is this is like a modernized kind. You can also do it manually by chopping it all up and mashing it all up yourself in a bowl. But the traditional way I was talking about in that people in my culture like to still do today, it's called a molcajete, and it's basically a big stone, like a rock, like a big stone, and it's shaped like a bowl typically, and then there's another stone, the same kind of stone that you use to mash the ingredients inside that circular stone bowl thing. Got a molcajete. You can go out and get one if you want, but this works as fine as well. And there is some effectiveness, like I said, to a molcajete. It is very effective. It's used to grind up the spices most of the time that you use in food and in guacamole. Guacamole spices like chili powders or onion powder or garlic, even like Anyway, with guacamole, you can grind up the spices with the stone, and then you can actually put the guacamole in there, and then that's when you mash up the guacamole. The guacamole does not come out as smooth. If you like smooth guacamole, I don't recommend using molcajete, because molcajetes leave a little bit of chunky avocado in there. But that's it. That's the effectiveness of it. It just brings out a different taste, because when you grind spices and things, it's a different flavor that it releases. So it does taste a little different when you use a molcajete. I will admit that, but I still prefer this. All right, let's get started. You will need a purple onion or red onion? it's a red onion, but I've heard people call it purple onion. Avocados, ripe ones, because you can't put hard ones in there. It'll be so annoying. Lime, tomato, garlic. I think this is onion powder, garlic powder, and I like to use chicken bouillon. I don't care if I tell people what I put in it, because I like sharing it, even if it's like secrets, because people make their guacamole their own way. But this is what I do, and I usually use a jalapeno, but my son really wants guacamole and he doesn't like the jalapeno, so I'm not gonna put jalapeno in there today. Okay. So I'm gonna go ahead and start with the onion. Cut this. Actually, don't even want that much, but it's too late. I already cut it. Don't judge my knife skills either. I'm not using the right knife. I'll cut that purple onion. Rip that baby off. Throw that away. I don't need all the onion. I don't like a whole bunch. I just use like this much, and then it gets chopped up in there. And even that's kind of a lot for me, my preference. Whatever. I just cut it in fours. And I toss it in this little lovely handy dandy thing. I like tomato in mine. So I'm just gonna throw those tomatoes in there. And this chopper is actually pretty good. You probably don't even have to do that, but I don't like messing with it too much. Just like it to be smooth and easy. So I think it's easier if you chop it up in fours, but whatever. Okay. All right, I'm actually gonna chop some of these up first before I put the avocados in there. Slide that thing and yeah, turn it. Bro, tell me that ain't like super easy. You still want to use a molcajete? Just kidding. Again, I'm not gonna rag on molcajete because it does give a good flavor, but I'm gonna chop that up more. I'm just stopping right there so I can add avocado in there. Don't forget to take stickers off. You don't want to eat that. I don't. I should have got a better knife, guys. I really should have, because this is like not smooth. I also hate these cutting boards. Don't ever buy these cutting boards unless they have a really good grip at the bottom, because this thing slides around like crazy and I'm always terrified that I'm gonna cut myself. Yeah, no. Okay, just throw that man boy. I'll be right here for now. I want to clean up white later. Right, and these you don't even have to cut either, but I'm just gonna cut it in fours as well. Slice in the middle, just like that, and I'm gonna go ahead and take a spoon and scoop that out. Lovely, beautiful, lovely, beautiful avocado. Ew, don't eat me. Oh, you gonna get eaten. Okay. These are nice and ripe. Yum, yum, yum. I might have put too much ingredients in there. I might have to empty that. Come on. All right, so I ended up using three avocados. I put them in there, cut them up. We are missing some lime juice, the garlic,
And then our seasoning. So let me just grab a couple cloves of garlic. I love garlic on everything, pretty much. So I like to use a lot of garlic. I'm gonna use 3 cloves. People probably typically use 2. I'm not sure, but this one looks a little fired. We'll just put that out. Sound like old. Anyway, there's some garlic in there. And there's probably an easier way to cut these too, but that's just the fastest way for me. There's another one, and we'll do one more. Uno más. Uno más. Uno más. Again, this has like a little gunky on it. I don't know what that is. It's probably just old sitting there. I don't know. And there's the guaca. I need one of these. I typically leave the bag. I don't know if you guys can see this, but I leave a bag in my sink there whenever I'm cutting so that I can put it all in the bag and throw it in the trash can because it's just easier that way. But there is this really cool thing I saw on Amazon, and it's like a big base looking thing that sits on your counter, but it has little trays underneath, and then on the top is a big thick cutting board, and then it has a slot, right? So you cut on it and then you slide the food right into there, or vice versa. If you're cutting, you can slide the trash into that little slot and it falls into the little box thing, and you take that box and you just throw it away. It's so cool, so quick and efficient and easy, and makes a lot of sense. And then you can, those little boxes from underneath, you can actually cover them and put them in the fridge, like they're storage containers. It's so crazy, but it's like so dope. I am definitely gonna get that, just probably not for this place, probably when I move, which hopefully will be soon. Yay! Okay, anyway, let's go ahead and squeeze some lime up in there. I'm gonna use a whole lime. Actually, I'm gonna use one lime and half a lime and see how it tastes first. My little rag. All right, some onion powder up in there. Ooh, some garlic powder. Yummy! See that? You can see all them seasonings. Ooh! Oh, yummy! I don't like to put too much of this because this chicken bouillon powder stuff is super salty. I wouldn't recommend throwing a bunch in the first time around. I would just put a little bit and then taste it from there. But let's go ahead and get this thing going. Just kidding. That was kind of annoying. But guys, this thing, look at that, is so crazy easy. Actually, I should make my grandma use this because she's like older. She might benefit from using it instead of struggling. Not sure, I might still get slapped, but whatever. Anyway, once you get the blades running, at first it's kind of slow. I'm not even advertising for this, by the way. True story. I used to work for this company years ago, and it was to practice my acting skills, and it was a company that sold this machine, maybe not this exact one, but just like this, and like magic, what are they called? Magic cloths, or I don't remember. And a magic broom. And I used to get up on this like little podium stage thing, and we used to go in grocery stores and we used to like display these. We used to make stuff and display with these things. So that's kind of crazy, isn't that how everything circles around sometimes? But whatever. And they didn't even buy this. This, like I said, this was handed to me from somebody else because they moved and they were like, hey, you want this? And I was like, yeah, I'll take it. But look how freaking fast and easy this works. Isn't that crazy? Again, I'll still probably get slammed. To be honest, I don't like the messy, uneven pieces, like at the top. It doesn't do it all the time. It's just when it's overfilled, and I did put a lot in here, so whatever. But I'm just gonna push that down, and then I don't know what that was. Probably just letting you know. And you know, I just closed it, but I actually should probably taste it now, though I can see what else I can add. Right now, it's still a little chunky. You see that? Okay. But it needs the other lime for sure. Yum. Yum. And I am going to put a little more of the bouillon because I don't taste the flavor yet. And I may need to add a little bit more. We'll see. But like I said, I don't like to overdo it. So I do my salt in portions. Let's go. I'm just kidding. But yeah, this definitely cuts in half the time. Again, this guacamole that I'm making right now does not have any spices because my kid doesn't like spice, like the jalapenos or the chili, you know, chili powder, whatever it is that you put spicing up your guacamole with. I can't add it right now because of my little man. I'm just gonna taste it again. So look at the consistency is getting better. Yum. All right. I do like the flavor, but I want it a lot smoother because I can taste some of the chunks of onion. And when you bite into some onions, they're like super potent. I don't know if that's really a good word. I might add just a little bit more. And you know what some of my family members use too, instead of using like the chicken bouillon and the powder separately, you can use garlic salt instead of garlic powder and this, but whatever. Actually, I'm gonna add a little bit more garlic. Cause y'all know me and my garlic. Okay, it doesn't wanna come out. There we go. Yes. Okay. Bye bye. Hands up. Bye bye. Whoa. Wonder what happens when you go the reverse way. Never done that. I'm sure it just probably blends it up even more. Guacamole. Oh my god, I have this video, you guys, of my kid when he was a little boy. I think he was like 1.5. No, he was 2. He was like 2.5 or something. And it is the cutest freaking thing ever. We were making guacamole. And he's singing this song. Guac-Eee-gamolie, Guac-Eee-gamolie, Guac-Eee-gamolie. And it is so cute. I'm going to post it right here on this video so you can see it because he's adorable. And he's not that little anymore. Okay, check out the consistency. Yeah. Yum. So it depends on if you want it more smoother, blend it more. If you want it chunkier, blend it less. You know, you get the idea. But I see a little seasoning right here, which I don't like. It's probably because I poured it right on there like a dodo. But I like that. Look at that. Oh my god, so delicious. Can you see that? Yumminess. Okay. Yes, perfect. Oh my god, you can taste the lime, the onion, the garlic, the avocado. Yum, you guys, this came out perfect. Yay! I'm gonna take it out, put it in a bowl, and eat it, and yum, yum, yum. Actually, 1 second. Forgot I had warmed this up earlier because I was eating leftovers. You can use chips, you can use quesadillas, but this is my lunch from yesterday. And it's like a brisket kind of quesadilla. Spices in it, obviously. I was warming it up just now so that I could eat it. And I'm going to dip it in here. I don't know if I want to dip it in there because that's somebody's. We'll use a spoon. Oh my gosh. That's good. Well, thank you so much, guacamole. I'm in heaven today. Yum. So I decided, screw it. My guacamole, ain't nobody else gonna eat it but me and maybe my kid. I'm gonna taste it right out of the container because I can. Now y'all be careful if you do that. Take the blade out first. That's some good guacamole. All right, guys. Thank you for being here. Joining me while I make this guacamole deliciousness. I'll post all the ingredients below in case you want to learn to make guacamole. You can add spices later. Remember that I didn't add spices in here. But if you like spice, you can add in jalapenos. You can add in more onion. You can add in like chili powders or crunched chilies. Totally up to you. And I will post the name of the cultural proper tool. I don't even know what to say about it, but the traditional Mexican culture tool that we use to make guacamole. Just in case you want to go look at it and try it out. It does, like I said, has its own effectiveness, so you can check out the difference if you want. Thank you again for being here. I love seeing you all. I love that sharing everything with you guys. If you liked what you saw today, if you liked the guacamole or Guac-Eee-gamolie, like my kid used to say, then like and subscribe to my channel and then hit the notifications button so you don't miss anything later. Until then, bye bye.
Guac-Eee-gamolie, 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 guac-Eee-gamolie.
You like that guacamole?
Yeah.